morning and welcome to Career TV e-learning program. We are telling you every day that make sure you subscribe so that you get these lessons and answer the questions correctly so that you post it to me and I will mark it for you. Subscribe and you will get those lessons. Thank you. Now let's continue. Last week, we started with the subject verb argument. And I told you we have rules for English language. And I took you through the rules. We have finished, we have ended at the rule 10. Left with two rules, which we will continue later. But today, before we do anything, let's come to what is ahead of us today. Now, today we are going to look at a certain topic or strand here. That is question tags. Question tags. And we are going to use auxiliary verbs. That is why I taught you linking or action verbs and auxiliary verbs. Without knowing your auxiliary verbs, you cannot do this. So you have to know your auxiliary verbs. And some of the auxiliary verbs that we are going to look at, using these verbs in question tags, are do, be, have, and can. We do more, but we can't write them all here. We have so many auxiliary verbs, and we cannot write all of them here. Now, when we say question tags, as it is on the board, we are going to look at the meaning of question itself before we know the meaning of question tags. When we say a question, what is a question? When we say a question is a statement that asks something. A question is a statement that asks something. You can also say questions are statements that ask something. Now you see, you look at the differences that I have made. I have given you these two sentences because I have taught you how to use the rules, how to use the singular verbs and then the singular plural. Hey, singular verb and then plural verbs. Yes. The singular subject and the plural subject. You remember? That is why I said a question, which is singular, singular subject. A question is a statement that asks, I've added this, that asks something. Or questions are statements that ask, without S, that ask something. So, Where is your book? It's a question. Where is your book? Let's look at this one. Has he come? It's a question. You are asking something. Has he come? And then, where is your book? It's a question. Okay, now let's look at question tags itself. I have explained the question for you. And then we are coming to question tags, when they add tags. When you say question tag, it is a question type. Listen. A question type expression. It is a question type expression that which is added at the end of a sentence. When you ask a question, then the expression which is also a question which you will add it at the end of that sentence is what we call a question tag. Or when you give any statement, it is not always a question, but it can be a statement. When you give any statement and you add any question to that statement, then it will be a question tag. That is what we call that question. You bring it at the end of that statement is what we call question tag. Okay. Before, let me write the question tag here. Yes. Question tag is a question type expression which is added at the end of a statement. And when you like a question, there will be a question. Has, let's use this one. Has, that is example. Has he come? Then you bring another thing here. What you will bring here is the tag we are talking about. The tag. This is a question, and the tag will come.
So you will say, say, hasn't he?
So this is what we call the tag. And because it is a question, that is why we call it a question tag. Question tag. Okay. So he has come. Then you bring another one. Okay. She's a girl. She's a girl. She's a girl. So the tag will be, isn't she? This is what we are going to do. This is what we are going to do. I know you will not understand how it came about, but that is what I'm going to teach you today. Okay. We have some statements that, look at this one. He has come. You see, when you say he has come, you have to know that, is this statement positive or negative? Positive, when you are doing question tags, we have two things you have to put it here. We have negative and we also have positive. Positive statements, negative statements, then positive tag, and then negative tag. So, positive and negative, like mathematics, we have positive one, negative one, but in English, we also have positive and negative. And in our real lives, when we say positive, you will see that something good. When we say negative, it is something bad. Okay, so in this case, in English, and then under question tag, when we say negative and then positive, the positive one is the statement that has no not. A statement that has no not. When I say a statement that has no not, she has come. You see that there's no not here. That is a positive. She is a girl. No not. But the negative is the statement that has not inside. He has not come. You see, so let me give you some negative and positive statement. Positive statement. Positive statement. Now, you see, examples. Some examples of positive statement. He has a book. It is a positive statement. Then negative, no, positive still. They can dance. Positive. I have a red pen. Positive. And look at some examples of negative statements. Negative statement. Negative statement. Negative statement. We are changing this negative statement. He has. Okay, he has no pen or no book, but that is how it will be. He is not here, let's use this word. He is not here. They can not dance. They cannot dance. I have not finished. You see? So not. Okay, let me. Not. What we are talking about. The moment you see not inside, not, it means they are negative statements. But here, there's no not here, so they are positive statements. In this case, when I was coming to teach, I made mention of auxiliary verbs. Look at them. S is here, auxiliary verb. Can, auxiliary verb. How, auxiliary verb. Can, how, has, they are all auxiliary verbs. Linking verbs. I said the subject and the verb must agree. Okay, now, we are now coming to the question tag. You see that? Whenever the statement is positive, the tag will be negative.
Negative, so it will be can't they statement with negative tag. Before I give you some examples. After that, let me give you some examples before. Could you and Ifua have come? Now, Kojo and Ifua will be there too. So there, and this is positive. There's no not here. So positive. So you say haven't, negative. Haven't, then this and this, they. Haven't they? Haven't they? Then, two. These are examples of this. She can write. Can't, then you write she. Simple. The last one. We will eat fufu.
So you just write can and she. You
There's no not. Here, not is here, so not will not come here. So she. Sorry. Can she? And always, the subject is last. The subject is at the last. The subject doesn't come first, but rather at the last. And the third one, we will not eat fufu. So it will be, this is will not, so not will not come, but rather will. Will we? So positive statement goes with negative tag, and negative statement goes with positive tag. Now let me teach you one thing, which will help you. So some of you don't know the negative of some of the auxiliary verbs. So let me draw a certain table and help you. So that you know it. Please, it is important to write it. Draw the table. This is the auxiliary verb. Okay, this is the verb. This is the verb plus not, and this is contracted form. When I say contracted form, it is short form. So when we have can, when you have can plus not, you will get can't.
Here is four. Let me come.
verse. Not, doesn't. 12. Shall plus not. Shan't. I shall die. So you just change this to negative, which is shan't. So shan't I, simple. Or he shall die, so shan't he. It's simple as ABC. This one, it comes in the BC. English objectives, you will see them there. So I can dance. Then you write the tag. Can't I? Why? Because this is put negative. Negative. So here must be positive. If here is positive, here must be negative. You have to use your senses. It's simple like that. When they give it to you, look at this one. Oh, this one is negative. Then it means here is positive. Or this one is positive. Or it means here is negative. Simple as ABC. So, and I have told you that here are the positive auxiliary verbs and here are the negative auxiliary verbs. Fine. So, exercise. Make sure you do this exercise. After that, post it using the line, the contact. I mean the contact on the screen so that I will mark it for you. He plays football well. I'm using this one as an example, but the rest I will allow you to do. As I look at this place, it's he plays football. There is no auxiliary verb here. This is an action verb, which you cannot say play plus not. So when you say play, you do what? You do some action. So it is do. You use do. He plays football. If it contains action, if the statement contains action word, and they didn't bring any auxiliary verb, which you are going to look at the negative and the positive of that auxiliary verb, it means that action verb you are going to use do. Do. If it is past tense, did. If it is a singular subject, does. So he plays football well. Good. Now, so this one is we represent it with do. And this one, this is he. So he, because it's singular, it's does. That is why I started teaching you this. He goes with yes. So he does. So here will be the negative for this. Doesn't he? If it is he played football, it will be didn't he? Okay. So I have done this for once. Be late. This one is inside. He is here. Study French. Don't forget the question mark. Can't back. He has finished. Must sleep now. And the last one, which is number 8, Kwame has a lot of pens. So see that this one is a negative statement. So the time tag must be positive. This one is positive statement, so the tag must be negative. Positive statement. They study. I have told you, this one is an action verb. So know what it is like this. I didn't bring auxiliary verb here. It's like this. So use this. So it comes back. It comes back. Negative statement. He has finished. Positive statement. We must sleep now. Positive statement. So the answer or the tag will be negative tag. Kwame has a lot of pens. Positive statement. So it will be negative tag. Thank you. You continue the next time we meet so that we look at the answer tags. This is question tags. We will look at the answer tags the next time we meet. Thank you for watching Kadriya TV. We'll meet again.